Hey there, Benjamin from Love's Data here, welcome back. Google has just announced their plan to sunset Universal Analytics next year. So if you're using the previous version of Google Analytics, you have until the end of June 2023 to transition to Google Analytics 4, GA4. In this video, I'm going to cover some important questions people are asking about moving from Universal Analytics to GA4. Since Universal Analytics will stop working next year, it's critical that you begin planning your move to GA4. So in a moment, I'm also going to show you how to quickly add GA4 in parallel to your existing Universal Analytics property. It also means it's a good time to start learning more about the features and reports available in GA4. So I've included links to my GA4 courses and extra resources in the description below this video. Okay, let's cover some important questions. What happens after June 2023? Your Universal Analytics properties will stop processing data into reports from the 1st of July 2023. You'll see zeros in your reports. Only historical data will be available. And if you're using the paid version of Google Analytics, so GA360, then you'll have 3 more months to migrate to GA4. What happens to data in Universal Analytics? Google has said you'll be able to access your historical data for at least 6 months after Universal Analytics stops processing data. This means you have until the end of December 2023 to download any historical data and insights. After this time, you won't be able to access any of your reports in Universal Analytics. How can I check which version of Google Analytics I'm using? It's pretty easy to check if you're using Universal Analytics or GA4. Let's head to Google Analytics to take a look. Okay, I've already logged into Google Analytics and we're looking at one of Google's demo properties. There are a couple of easy ways to tell if you're looking at Universal Analytics or GA4. The first thing to look at is the main menu on the left. If you hover over the menu and see Home, Reports, Explore, Advertising, and Configure, then you're looking at a GA4 property. The other way to tell is by selecting the property and View Selector at the top. You might find that your GA4 property has a name that makes it easy to tell, like we can see here, but this isn't always the case. Instead, look at the property ID below the name. We can see the ID is 21302-5502. If this ID only contains numbers, then you're looking at a GA4 property. But we can see below this, the other property has an ID that starts with a UA. So this is a Universal Analytics property. Let's select the Universal Analytics property. You will also see that Universal Analytics properties contain reporting views. So let's select a reporting view. You will notice the menu is different to what we saw in GA4. Remember, if you see Home, Reports, Explore, Advertising, and Configure, then you're looking at a GA4 property. Since we can't see Reports, Explore, Advertising, or Configure in the menu, this means we're looking at a Universal Analytics property. Now let's select Admin. Since we're looking at the Admin area for a Universal Analytics property, we can see there are 3 columns. So this is another way to tell what type of property you're looking at. If we select a GA4 property, then there are only 2 columns. So there's some different ways you can identify if you're using Universal Analytics or GA4. Can I upgrade Universal Analytics to GA4? Unfortunately, you can't simply upgrade your Universal Analytics property to a GA4 property. Instead, you will need to set up a new GA4 property in parallel to your existing Universal Analytics property. Can I move data from Universal Analytics to GA4? No, unfortunately this isn't possible. There is no way to import data from Universal Analytics into GA4. The best option is to set up GA4 in parallel to Universal Analytics. Let's take a look at the steps to set up GA4 in parallel to your existing Universal Analytics property. One of the easiest ways to get up and running is to use the GA4 Setup Assistant. Let's select this. I recommend using the option at the top that says, I want to create a new Google Analytics 4 property. So let's click Get Started. The option to collect data using your existing tag might be available for your property, but my suggestion is to install the tag separately using Google Tag Manager. So leave this option deselected and click Create Property. Now click See Your GA4 Property. Google Analytics provides some recommended steps to help you get started. So let's select Tag Installation. Now we need to select the data stream. And on the top right corner, you will see the measurement ID. Let's copy this. And now let's head to Google Tag Manager. We need to create a new tag. Let's name the tag Google Analytics GA4. And let's select Tag Configuration. We need to choose GA4 Configuration as the tag type. And now we need to paste the measurement ID we just copied. Now let's select Triggering. And select All Pages. This will mean our new GA4 tag will fire on all of the pages of our website. Now we can save the tag. You can preview the tag to check that the tag is firing correctly, but I'm happy with my tag, so I'm going to click Submit. I've now added GA4 to my website in parallel to the existing Universal Analytics tag. So they're the steps to add the GA4 tag to your website. This will now automatically collect page views and details about some other important actions taking place on your website. If you've implemented any customizations, then you'll also need to set these up in Google Tag Manager so that they're sent to Google Analytics. How do I set up and configure GA4? If you're using Universal Analytics, I recommend listing out any customizations you've made. Think event tracking, filters, and e-commerce tracking. Then you can use this list to ensure you replicate those customizations in GA4. I've included a link to get my GA4 checklist in the description below this video. How can I learn more about GA4? I've included links to my other GA4 tutorials on YouTube in the description below this video. And if you're looking for a course to guide you through everything you need to know about GA4, then check out my courses. I've also included links in the description. So there's some of the most important questions people are asking about moving from Universal Analytics to GA4. I'm also working on a GA4 FAQ video, so if you have another question you'd like to see me answer, there's a link in the description that will let you submit your GA4 questions. Are you using GA4 yet? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video useful, please like it so I know to make more videos like this one. I'll see you in the next video.